Before we begin, I'd like to bring to your attention the fact that when these books, such as Matthew, Mark, Luke, John, Acts, Romans, 1st, 2nd Corinthians, Galatians, Ephesians, Philippians, Colossians, 1st, 2nd Thessalonians, all the way down to Revelations, including 1st John here, were written, that the only books that they had prior to this was the Torah. And the Torah is Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, and Deuteronomy. That's the thing that everybody had. Everybody had the Torah. They would go into the synagogues on Shabbat and they would be read the Torah. We are told in the Old Testament that we should keep the Torah on our hearts, minds, and souls, and that the path to our Father is based upon the Torah. And modern day Christianity will have us believe that the laws of God are on the cross and that we do not have to follow the laws of God anymore because our Messiah, Yahushua HaMashiach, or as a lot of people call him, Jesus the Christ, they believe that we don't have to follow them because he paid the price for them. He walked them. And so we don't have to. So that is a lot like saying you can run a red light, get a ticket for the red light, and because you got that ticket and paid that ticket, you can run every red light out there. The consequences of running red lights is that you will probably end up getting T-boned and killed. That is the curse of breaking that kind of a law. It's very basic. Same with jaywalking. You're not supposed to walk across a street, and they have those rules because people don't look both ways and they walk across the street and they get smashed. And so if you don't understand the laws of God, you will never understand sin. A lot of people say that the word is gone, right? The word of God is no longer important. They say it's not something we should know. It's not something we should memorize. And on those aspects, I would like to bring up 1 John 1 and go with this. Actually, 1 John 2. My little children, these things I write unto you, that ye sin not. And if any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Yahushua HaMashiach, the righteous. So what is that saying right there? It says that we should not sin. The first thing is, if you do not know the law and you are one of those people that have put the laws of God on the cross, you will not know what sin is. The Christians will go, hold on. We have the Holy Spirit. We have the Ruach of our Creator, and we will know right from wrong. That is not true, because I see a lot of the Christians, modern day Christians, they're eating pork. They're eating medium rare steaks with blood in it. They eat the fat that is around that. And all those things right there, we are told not to do. And we wouldn't know this unless we kept the Torah and knew the Torah. So simply by reading the Torah, we are able to educate ourselves and we know what sin is because of this. Verse 2, and he is the propitiation for our sins, and not for ours only, but also for the sins of the whole world. That's self-explanatory, right? It is by his death, burial, and resurrection that we are able to plead that blood. He conquered death. He became the curse. Cursed is every man who is hung on a tree, right? He became the curse for us so that we don't have to die that spiritual death of the Torah. The laws of the Torah are for us today, tomorrow, and for all times. If we don't keep that and we don't understand that, then we will live in sin, and it makes the blood sacrifice that our Messiah did, it makes it a sin card to where we sin over and over and over, and we can get up the next day, we can start again, and that's the way it is. But then by the end of the day, we are back into pornography, we're back into whatever it is that we are destroying our lives with. Verse 3, and hereby we do know that we know him if we guard his commandments. Right there, the Christians will say, look, Jesus, Yahushua, had two commandments. Love God with all your heart, mind, and soul, and love your neighbor as yourself. So is John talking about those two commandments? And if he was talking about those two commandments, and it is to love God with all your heart, mind, and soul, and you have taken the laws of God and tossed them in the trash, then you can't possibly love God with all your heart, mind, and soul, because you don't know what his will is for you if you do not know the law. So if we are to know him, and we're talking either Yahuwah, God, or Yahushua, his son, we are supposed to guard his commandments. How can you guard his commandments when you put them in the trash? He that says, I know him, verse 4, and guards not his commandments is a liar, and the truth is not in him. But whoso guards his word, what is the word, guys? The word is the Torah. In him truly is the love of Elohim perfected. Hereby know that we are in him. It says that if you keep and guard the word of God, which is the Torah, the love of Elohim is perfected in you. That is what this is all about. Will you walk with our Creator, or will you take that other path that leads to destruction? But whoso guards his words, in him truly is the love of Elohim perfected. Hereby we know that we are in him. Verse 6, he that says he abides in him ought himself also to walk even as he walked. So what does this mean? Even as he walked. Our Messiah, Yahushua HaMashiach, walked out the Torah. He became the Torah in living flesh, and he walked it to a perfection. He did not sin. He did not go against the Torah. He lived it. He kept the feast. He kept the Torah. He kept the Shabbat. And his message to the Pharisees and Sadducees, who did not keep the laws of God, they kept the oral Torah and the traditions of men and a bunch of other stuff. So even as he walked, how did he walk? Our Messiah walked in the Torah. So it says, he that says he abides in him ought all him also himself also to walk, even as he walked. So we're supposed to walk as our Messiah walked, which was in the laws, statutes, and commands of our Father. Brethren, I write no new commandment unto you, but an old commandment, which ye had from the beginning. What is it? What do we have from the beginning? When these guys were talking about this, there was nothing that they had from the beginning except the Torah. Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, and Deuteronomy. The old commandment is the word which ye have heard from the beginning, right? And it applies today, not just the Ten Commandments, which is the moral law, which most people get a 60% on anyway, but it's the other stuff. We're supposed to keep it all, and you won't know what you're supposed to keep until you start reading it. Let's go in verse 8. Again, a new commandment I write unto you, which thing is true in him and in you, because the darkness is past and the true light now shines. So these are kind of confusing, because you have verse 7, which says, I write no new commandment unto you, but an old commandment. So when he's saying a new commandment, this new commandment is the old commandment. So this commandment that he writes unto to him is that we're supposed to keep the laws, statutes, and commands that we are supposed to be kept from the very beginning. So this is very confusing to a lot of people, and I will go to my deathbed saying that the laws, statutes, and commands are good for all generations, for all time. And you get things with this. You either get blessings for keeping them, or you get curses for not keeping them. So guys, as we learn the Torah, as we come into Torah with our Father, with our Creator, and learn to love his laws, statutes, and commands, I urge you guys to read Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, and Deuteronomy. Read the books, which are the Torah, right? The Torah, right at the top. Torah means instruction. Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, and Deuteronomy. And if you just want a synopsis of exactly the quick go-to guide of where you're supposed to do this, start in Deuteronomy. Deuteronomy is where it's a compilation of everything. It's a reminder of Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, and Numbers. So if you're looking for a path, if you're looking for the way to be, my friends, it is inside the Torah. It is walking with our Creator. It is calling upon the name of his son, Yahushua HaMashiach. And there's only one name under heaven by which you may be saved. And this man that everybody calls Jesus, Jesus, there were no J's in Greek, right? Or there are J's in Greek. There were no J's in Hebrew. So if you're looking at a man, he was a Hebrew man. He would have never been called Jesus. It would, and in fact, that is the King James hoax. In 1611, they went from I-E-S-U-S, which was still a hoax because his name is an Isis, to Jesus, right? it's getting further away. And if you know the name of the Messiah, I like to be called my name. I don't want to be called Bob when my name is Jason. So if you're calling me Bob, I probably won't even look at you. I don't know you're talking to me. Is that the same if there's only one heaven? If there's only one name under heaven by which you may be saved, that is Yahushua HaMashiach. I hope you guys are good. I'm out.